is like when the creek cross a big rocky part, there are some holes naturally made, you know, sometimes.
Where the water will...
And so inside the holes, because it's very heavy.
It's quite a heavy rock.
Yeah. So if these rocks are somewhere where the creek goes, you will find them inside these holes, for example. That's one way to find them. Or if you know the geology of the area, you might know where to find them. They come, they're about 80 million years old. They were made at one moment on Earth, and so they are related to
that time
layer.
Frame.
Yeah, the time frame, and the layer that you might find in some places, but here for Saskatchewan, I honestly have no idea. And it's not the only stone, though. These ones are round, but I know some places they are actually flat. You find like a layer, a sedimentary layer, that is made out of, so you can just break pieces and you get sparks. So people would trade that kind of stone, long way. And once again, I don't have enough information for here and what Cree people used to trade on not in this region, but it would be interesting actually. I'm pretty sure we know about that. If they had this kind of stone, if they would trade them, if they were coming from north or south. So the way to use this is slightly different than the other one. Here we have less sparks, we don't see them right now. But the spark lasts longer because they have sulfur that provides them with fuel. So actually, if we could compare the distance and therefore the life of a spark with this lighter, the sparks, they don't go very far. About, I don't know, you know, half a foot, maybe. These ones, if we were in the night, you would see them falling for almost a second or two. Yeah, they would go about that distance. So they last longer. So you need a different material to get these sparks, to light something. So that's where this fungus, I chopped the one that I harvested here on. So the whole fungus would be about that big.
Like off
a tree?
Could
be really big. They grow on birch
trees.
And we have some here around. So I usually just take the upper part, and in there is a material very specific. I think where did I put it? I had, when I started the week, a piece here. It's not the best example, it could be softer than this, but anyway, you can actually cut slides of this fungus and use this actually as a coagulant if you cut yourself.
That's good information.
Yeah. And I always carry some pieces with me just in case if someone cut himself.
Look at that band-aid.